Dhruva. Uttanapada was the son of Swayambhuva Munu and brother of Devahuti and Prasuti. He had two wives, Suruchi, good taste, and Suniti, good sense. The king was more fond of Suruchi. Suruchi had a son called Uttama and Suniti a son called Dhruva. One day, the king was sitting on the throne. Suruchi was nearby. Uttama went up the throne and sat on the lap of the king. Dhruva, who was also playing with him, went up to get up the throne to reach the father's lap. The king did not pay any attention to him but was fondling Uttama. Suruchi went forward and pushed away Dhruva from getting up, saying that he was not fortunate enough to get up there. If he really wanted to reach there, he must go and beseech Lord Narayana and get reborn in her womb. Since he was not born to her now, he could not aspire for the place. The king made no protest for these words. Dhruva, who was only 5 years of age, felt badly humiliated. He began to cry and went to his mother. Suniti heard his cry and the reason thereof from the maids. She also began to weep for the unhappy lot of both of them. She advised Dhruva not to have ill will towards anybody, but to seek shelter in the Lord as advised by his stepmother. He alone could make him happy. The insult had worked too deeply on Dhruva and he started from home in search of him. On the way, sage Narada met him, inquired about his distress and made light of the matter, saying, "For a young boy, where can there be any shame?" Then he made much of the possible dangers ahead of his attempt, but found the boy undeterred in his resolve. Narada found him to be a fully qualified seeker, instructed him in the various steps for undertaking tapas, bathing, cleanliness, seating, asana, breath control, etc. And then initiated him to the sacred 12-syllabled mantra, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, and directed him to repeat it and succeed in his attempt. As per Narada's advice, Dhruva reached the Madhuvana on the banks of Yamuna near Mathura, bathed thrice a day, sat in a clean place with some improvised seat, and started pranayama and began to do tapas with the sacred mantra taught by the celestial sage. Narada then went to King Uttanapada, who was stricken with grief for the loss of a noble son, Dhruva, due mainly to his own neglect and over-attachment to his younger wife, Suruchi. He had given up all hope of seeing Dhruva again. Narada relieved him of his anxiety, saying that Dhruva was a great soul and that he would return back with the greatest gain and that he need not feel sorry for him. Dhruva continued his tapas, eating fruits once in 3 days for a month, dried leaves once in 6 days for the second month, drank water once in 9 days for the third month, then once in 12 days he used to take in air for the fourth month, and left off taking anything during the fifth month. He stood firmly on one foot and concentrated the mind on his heart. By the force of his tapas, all the worlds began to tremble. The celestials sought protection from Lord Vishnu for fear that something bad was going to happen. The Lord consoled them, explaining Dhruva's tapas and promised that he was going to do the needful. Lord Vishnu arrived on his vehicle Garuda at where Dhruva was meditating. Immediately, the image of the Lord on which Dhruva was concentrating in his heart disappeared. Dhruva opened his eyes to behold him standing in his front. Dhruva prostrated to the Lord and stood up with folded hands. Observing the boy's incapacity to speak, the Lord touched his head with his conch, the symbol of the Vedas, and Dhruva began to praise him with full eloquence, Mukam Karoti Vachalam. The Lord was much pleased with him and granted him his wish, that Dhruva, after his father crowned him, would rule the kingdom for many years and then attain the status of the permanent star, pole star, which would not perish even in the greatest deluge. That status is called Dhruvapadam, the permanent abode. The Lord then returned to his abode. When the Lord had gone, Dhruva realized that he had been a fool to have asked for material gains when he could have easily asked the Lord for liberation and avoided all further pains. That he was deluded by Maya, that his intellect was dulled and misdirected. He had missed the greatest chance. He cursed himself and returned home. When Uttanapada was informed of the approach of Dhruva, he would not believe his ears. He had taken him to have been lost forever. Dhruva was received by the king and the people with great honor and taken to the palace. He prostrated to his father, his two mothers, and embraced his brother. He was highly respected by everybody. When he came of age, he was placed on the throne and his father left for the forest in search of God. Dhruva married Brahmi, daughter of Sisumara Prajapati, and had two sons, and also Ila, the daughter of Vayu, wind god, and had a son and a daughter. His brother Uttama, who was a bachelor, one day went to the forest for hunting and was killed by a yaksha, an attendant of Kubera, god of wealth. His mother Suruchi went in search of him and was burnt in a forest fire. Dhruva grew very angry for the loss of his brother and so went with an army for war and reached Alakapuri, the capital of Kubera. He began to pin arrows on every yaksha. They were no match for him. The yakshas jointly fell on him at one time. Even then, he drove them all away. Then they began their magic tricks on him, but he took up the missile called after Sri Narayana and all their magic vanished into thin air. Then Swayambhuva Manu, grandfather of Dhruva, appeared on the scene and chastised Dhruva for his unrighteous act in killing so many innocent yakshas for the sake of one. It was unbecoming of a devotee of the Lord and a descendant of the dynasty of Brahma. A devotee must have respect for saints, friendship for equals, pity for the low, equality for all living creatures. Then only God would be pleased with him. He advised Dhruva to beg pardon of Kubera, the lord of yakshas, and to leave off anger and its consequent pitfalls. Dhruva accordingly put down his bow and arrows and began to praise Kubera for forgiveness. Kubera was much pleased with him because he had renounced his anger. He told him that the yaksha did not kill his brother, nor all the yakshas who have died. It was all the work of providence. So he advised Dhruva to serve the Lord in every way possible so that he might beget all auspiciousness. He instructed him in the method of serving the Lord and went away. Dhruva returned to his palace. He performed many sacrifices, ruled over the country with righteousness, treated the people as his children. After 26,000 years of precious rule, he placed his son on the throne and moved to Badrikashrama in the Himalayas and began to meditate on the Lord. While he was fully immersed in Samadhi, a celestial car with two conductors came to take him to Vaikuntha, and the conductors requested him to get into it. Dhruva went round the plain and was about to place his foot in the plain when he remembered his beloved mother. The conductors showed him another plain that was already going in advance, wherein his mother was seated. He was much pleased and reached Vaikuntha, from where he was allotted the place of the pole star, the Dhruva Nakshatra, around which the other stars, including the Saptarishis, revolve. It is a guiding star for navigators in the sea at night and for householders, the eternal navigators on the sea of samsara during the day. That is, it is the guiding intellect for right living.